And we're back again, guys, here for the knife round.
That game is
already over.
For the game two of the shootout season three, presented by, powered by MixBot, presented by Mineski TV, and this is game two.
No, it's presented by MixBot, coverage by Mineski TV.
Ah, there you go. Yeah.
Number one esports channel in the Philippines. Well, reintroduce ourselves. I'm Master Eye, you're one hell of a beast. And of course, my co-caster here is...
Nomad, not one hell of a beast, but still a beast, you know. No, I'm saying. But yeah, this is Train. This is JYP's pick, so they might be able to turn things around here.
Yeah, Train, definitely a map that you have to know your set smokes. I mean, that's also true in all of the maps, but... I think Train is in a special place in my heart that you have to know the map, the smoke sets.
I thought Cobble was the.
I mean, for the smokes, not my favorite map.
Oh, for the smokes, yeah, and yeah, things might be different this time around. JYP may be able to, they may be able to come back and actually force a reverse sweep, and that is what we want to see. Beautiful Counter-Strike all together.
Yeah. But right now, Rekka Esports finds the one kill onto PZ Kid, so... Well, it's still just a start. Can't say no to that just yet.
Can't say no to that, indeed. And Rekka Esports still has a mana advantage, not Ooh, anymore. Anna with a headshot through the smoke, just with the pre-fires there. And JYP is now storming into the site for the retake, and Rekka Esports is now... trying to go for the bomb plant here, and it's just down to Celeste on its own, but it's not going to happen. Rekka Esports, again, takes the pistol round on the first half of the game.
Wow, they actually just charged in and didn't get to connect their shots, but still, Rekka Esports able to finish it off in the end, and they'll be at least getting a little bit of momentum in this game. But JYP is going to say, you know what, we've had it, we're going to be force buying into the second round and try to counter you guys, but Rekka Esports... with a whole bunch of SMGs and utilities, so this is gonna be a fast-paced second round here.
Yeah, and JYP force buying the UMPs and the scout. It might be useful, but you know, let's see if it's gonna pay off, because Rekka Esports has the armors and the helmets, they're not gonna be able to do that much damage, but they do have the firepower, and Rizzo takes down Anna, taking out the scout that they have. And it's now quickly down to a 5v4 situation. Rekka Esports is going in for the kill here at A site. Down to a 5v2 situation. No, make that a 5v1. They are just wrecking Hammer. Amen actually forces a bomb drop. Almost takes out Benta there, but it's not going to happen. 2-0, still in favor of Rekka Esports.
Yeah, but still, they get at least the one kill onto X-Crit, which kind of denied the bomb plant. But at the same time, JYP... that would have been... You know, if they got more kills, that would have been more acceptable for them.
If they had more kills, but, you know, we'll see what's gonna happen there. JYP not looking good economically here. They are stuck with the default pistols and a couple of P250s. No utilities whatsoever. They just need to, hold down the site as much as they can, and that's not gonna happen. It's just quickly down to a 1v1 situation. ACAP on his own, he's not gonna be able to do much. I mean, he could go for the kill and steal a gun. That's the best thing that he can do, but the hunt is now on for ACAP as Rekka Esports now storm B site, and he is gonna go down.
Nice dink onto Rizzo though, but no joy for that one, to no avail. And JYP finally on their first buy round.
Indeed. A blue shell effect is taking over. They're not going to be able to do much, especially with Celeste with that glass cannon AWP. But good thing he has the two flashes there. That's going to be good.
Let's see. I'm curious because X-Crit also buying himself an AWP, and they might meet themselves through mid. But X-Crit connects the shot first, and he wins that duel, mano e mano,
man to man.
Yeah.
Just for the translation, just in case you guys. Need a translation.
Your translation for that, well.
No, I'm sorry.
Easy Kid with the smoke. He's gonna at least stop a little bit the push that Rekka Esports are looking to go from Ivy area. But with that one kill that X-Crit got, I think Rekka Esports are just okay with testing out the waters, trying to maybe catch off rotation JYP here. I know. Does have a swag 7 here at Pop Dog. Definitely one of the spots where, you know, we do see. Wow. I was gonna say, like, JW likes to go for that Pop Dog swag 7, but he missed all of those taps. And Acap comes down to there to join the party, but Racket Esports still able to win this with only Super Sis being that casualty for them.
Yeah, 4-0. Racket Esports is still in the lead. And we don't know what's gonna happen at this point. Well, we know what's gonna happen at this point. Racket Esports is still feeling confident. JYP, they're feeling all the pressure in the world here to actually get at least 2 rounds in so that they can boost up their confidence. The confidence that they had during the first game was so significant they were able to go for almost a comeback, but it's not apparent here. Racket Esports is just racking up the rounds after rounds. We'll see. We'll just see what's gonna happen here. And Acap.
Wait, did they hear that Nate actually touched his body? No, he can actually go for the backstab, but Frost Misty one step ahead of him, not gonna allow anybody to actually go from behind. And at full control on the bomb site B, JYP has to go for the retake here, or at least go for those exit frags. But
a backstab of the backstab.
Yeah. The backstab, the backstab. Counter backstab.
Counter backstab. And yeah, JYP with the Deagle, the 5-7 and USB. That's not gonna be enough against a fully bought Racket Esports. They're just gonna hide, just deny Racket Esports of the economy that they'll get by just simply falling down. Super PZ Kid had the angle there.
I think his brain lagged or something from that one. I mean,
he already had the angle and he
yeah.
And Celeste goes down as well.
And Ana not gonna be able to save his 5-7. Dies in Pop Dog.
And he exploded.
Yeah. And he's just gonna say, "Whoop, yep, whoop." That's life. That's life.
But yeah, a huge shout out there for every single person watching the stream. We are very grateful for your viewership. Much love to the Southeast Asian esports community.
Yeah, much love. Oh, Xcurate. He's gonna go aggressive. Actually goes down hard on top of Pop Dog. Spots out Celeste. Can he actually hit the shot? Celeste knows where he is now. And he is stubborn with his angle.
Forcing out the retreat there with that smoke onto Pop Dog. Down to a 5v4 situation. You know, JYP is just, it's actually a pretty heavy ace stack here. If Racket Esports decides to go to B, that's going to be the death of them.
Oh man, imagine if Racket Esports come again with like a 13-2 and it pushes to like 13-10 or 15-10. Ay, that's gonna be stressful.
I mean, if JYP comes back, that's gonna, you know, spark some questions onto Racket, like, what are they doing wrong? What do we need to do? What are we lacking? Why are we not securing the round? Why are we not securing the game? I mean,
I think it's just, you know, Racket Esports have difficulty on their T side. That's just it. Because by default, wait, hold that thought first. Frost Misty's gonna push himself in.
Acap takes down Frost Misty as he went in, and is now down to a 5v3 situation. And PZ Kid takes down Super Sis once again. I think this is slowly gonna look like a JYP game, and it's just Bentet on his own. He's gonna need to try to save, well, he doesn't need to save the AK, he has enough money to buy up next round. He's just gonna survive the onslaught, and Bentet takes down that cap, and he's gonna try to force a bomb flat, even though the Molotov's right there, and it gets taken down by Amen. And it's now 1-5. JYP is back in the game. They finally have the round in.
Yeah, and they saved 4 weapons for that one, so they will be able to at least stack up a little bit of economy for them to work with into this next round. And Racket Esports, of course, can buy for days as they've won 5 straight rounds and got a whole lot of bomb plans as well.
And that's gonna give them an economical advantage over Racket Esports. I mean, they can afford to lose the guns. JYP, they don't have the luxury there.
Yeah. Racket Esports definitely don't want, or rather, JYP definitely don't want to lose this round, because the chance to fight for $100,000 Australian dollars is at stake here, guys.
And yeah, they will be flying to Australia for the Zen League presented by ESL. And the pressure is on. who's going to fly there. And A-Man with in an off angler actually takes him down. And Celeste takes down Super Sis. Down to a 4v3 situation. Akap spraying wildly in the smoke and it's not going to connect to anywhere. Celeste and Anna. Woo! Celeste with actually the double kill there. And it's just Frost Missy on his own. They know he's in the power box. And Frost Missy gonna try to see if he can take it back to them. It's now down to a 1v1 situation. Pufflash is gonna come in. His
That was so close, though.
That was so close. And Rekka Esports once again seals the deal.
A little bit slow on the quick scope there for Celeste, but he went a little bit wild, though not enough. That was some opping from the man himself.
And yeah, Frost Misty, what a clutch. Can we have a look at the scoreboard real quick? So Frost Misty is actually in the lead with 9 kills, followed by Rizzo. A-Man, on the other hand, is the leading in the counter-terror side with 5 kills. Man, this speaks a lot, stats-wise, and the assault is now on for Rekka Esports.
And now they're gonna try to at least defend this and get away some kills against Rekka. And they do find the one. A-Man gonna try to reload, but he's gonna get caught out by the guy in the side that's gonna be Bentet, racking up the 2 kills. And actually, this is a pretty good from JYP. I mean, they could actually maybe not clutch this, but they got 3 kills in the pistol round. Though at the same time, that Bob will get planted for the B site, and PZ Kid has a whole lot of ground to cover. He doesn't know where Rekka Esports are. Maybe the one guy in Pop Dog, but he's already skedaddled on out of there.
Yeah,
and yes.
And yeah, PZ Kid, he needs to. He is gonna go for the
extra test angle too.
Yeah,
he's gonna peek it. No, wait.
Let me just crouch.
He's gonna go for it.
Is he peeking? When is he coming out? This is Snake.
I think he's just gonna look for exit frag already.
Yeah.
Oh,
it just caught off guard, PZ Kid.
The timing.
But he's not gonna be able to get the AWP.
It's all right. As long as he, you know, denies as much money from Rekka Esports, JYP are getting all these small victories, though. At the same time, well, it's just small victories. Rekka Esports still have cash to work with for days, and JYP are, yet again, sort of broken in terms of their economy. Will they force buy?
And they did go for the force buy.
They didn't go for the force buy. They just went for a weak buy.
Partial buy. Yeah, and
actually, that's a terminology that people use already. The weak in means that it's well, it's a shorthanded buy, or if like in terms of like if you're playing, you tell your teammate that guy's weak. It just means that he's low in HP. They use the term already. It's not for trash talk or anything. It's an accepted term now.
It's been 2 months since I last played Counter Strike. Wow.
Wow.
Things have changed.
Yeah, they do.
Oh man, I need to start playing. My rank's gonna decay. No, they are not two girls playing. X-Crit. Oh, I'm sorry. Anna and Celeste, they are. Anna is Sever, and Celeste is Kaze.
I don't know how to pronounce it. Kaze or Kaze?
Kaze. I don't know. I'll just go for Kaze. Safe.
Oh, the pop flash though. That could be huge for Akap here. He gets the one. For more, but wow, Rizzo with the backstab there, and at the end, at the edge of it all, it's gonna be at the edge of B side, right? It's going to be PZ Kid, but he was smoked off, and
now he's flashed up.
Yeah, right. Esports having the control of B side,
and Bentet takes down Anna's now down to a 4v2 situation as A-Man actually goes down. They're just gonna go for the retakes here, but I think they're actually in a position to go for the defuse if they want to.
I don't think they can. They're so far
and they don't have kits. Yeah, it makes
exactly.
sense.
They're at the edge of the site, so saving this weapon definitely will help out into the next round. But Rekka Esports getting the one up again and X-Crit?
Okay. Just pull the trigger, X-Crit. That would have been your kill.
Another round for Rekka Esports.
And JYP within one round, we're slowly going into the end of the first half.
So far, X-Crit didn't play well in this game. Actually, I have to counter you on that one. Nova Janus. This best of three, X-Crit has played
surprisingly well compared to his...
Surprisingly better than in the whole tournament. In this whole tournament. I'm not saying, you know, in his previous games in other tournaments, but just this one. He has been under in terms of his player skill as the AWPer.
Yeah, and Expert, he was missing most of the shots. Every time you say AWP, hold that thought, Frost misses, he takes down ACAP, and the take is now on for B. Rekka Esports is now storming to the side, the smokes are now coming in, and JYP, they are starting to rotate. Supersys takes down Aemon, it's now down to a 5v2 situation. The Molotov is going to force out PZ Kid out of there. It's going to add more time for Rekka Esports to actually go ahead and plant the bombs now down to Celeste and PZ Kid. They just need to save the weapons right now at this point. They will not have enough money to work with in the next round. They could just buy their teammates, but...
JYP have been losing all of their aim duels, and well, Rekka Esports, I mean, all they do is actually just set up standard smokes onto either B or A, and they go in. After that, it's just them winning out these duels, and JYP, well, yeah, granted, they can actually just counter out Rekka Esports by getting the kills after the bomb has been planted, but they are in no position to actually go for the retake or the defuse, so... Even if they're like, getting all these cheeky kills, it's still not enough.
Yeah, and oh, JYP goes down. The M4 and the AWP is no longer their possession.
Why use girls' names for?
It's
their girlfriends. It's for inspiration.
Yeah, I mean, this is a tournament. You know, they need all the inspiration that they can get. And yeah, well, I take back what I said. They actually have enough money to work with, but you know, saving that extra $3,000, that's gonna be big for the next round.
True enough. Yeah, that's true. Oh. Are they actually gonna push aggressive here? Look at ACAP's positioning there. He's gonna charge in, but actually gets caught out. He admits of it all. And now it's gonna be Celesta with the defense at the end of the smoke. Gets the two. Looks for the third. Through the smoke as well, but not gonna happen, bro. 2v3 though. Definitely now a chance for JYP to get that one round in. Xquid will get a little bit overwhelmed here, but he is surviving for the longest time. And now Aemon left into a 1v1 situation against Supersys. Aemon trying to wrap around through the boxes here, or through the cargo and the electric box. He's playing at the edge of the smoke, and this is a game of hide and seek. Supersys is trying to look for Aemon, but oh, that's almost a catch off onto Aemon there. The bomb is directly in front of Supersys, but he doesn't want to take it up to get it just yet, because he knows there's 50 seconds left on the clock, and they are running circles at each other. Look at the positioning here. I think
JYP's gonna actually catch him off guard here if he just comes down to the right angle.
This could be it. Does he find it? Yes, he does. He's gonna go for the backstab, and he shuts Supersys down. I think Aemon Supersys felt a little bit too confident on that one. It felt a little bit too safe. He still had time, though. He didn't have to actually go for the defuse.
No, that's actually pretty smart. Denying the enemy from planting the bomb. That's actually a big impact because... I mean, think about it. They won't have the extra money.
Yeah, no. I meant, like, why did he have to go for the bomb plant? I was talking about Supersys. He had a lot of time. So... Plus, he could just actually have just rotated to B to have a safer plant. But yeah, you know what?
Maybe it's just the pressure kicking in.
Could be.
But oh, a couple of retakes happening there immediately as JYP is actually falling down. It's now down to a 4v3 situation. Rekka Esports is still pretty chill with the takes here. They haven't leaned towards a single site yet.
Oh, and Rousseau with the backstab.
And Supersys takes down Anna at the same time to give Celeste on his own. But he's not going to run away with the AWP. Rekka Esports once again takes another round, 10-2.
Alright, so I kind of wonder, this is like worst case scenario for JYP. Yes, they're getting these one rounds off of Rekka Esports, but... You have to note, every time you do lose, you know, as you win one round, your the round bonus or the round loss bonus actually resets, and when they lose the next round, they don't have any money to work with. Or it should be like maybe just 2,000, 2,500 that they can display. Not enough for a full buy.
Not enough for the full buy, yeah. And we already saw the rain of fires coming in from Rekka, and it's now 4v2. Aemon actually picks up the AK-47, And PZ Kid is just going to try and see if he can go for a couple of kills. He could actually take down that guy on top of green, but it's not going to happen. A-Man's just going to run away with the AK-47, give that to his teammates, or just possibly keep it. And the rain of fire is now coming in.
There's a couple of people saying Rekka goes to Australia. I think they should do like a vlog and then see how...
And that's the title of their blog.
Yeah, how this team actually reacts to the...
Oh, what?
Bented was on the railing.
Oh, I thought it was through the wall.
No. It was on the railing. Yeah, how Rekka Esports, a Southeast Asian team, reacts to Australian food.
That can be content. Hey, Rekka Esports, just
is,
in case.
Is crocodile meat illegal?
Crocodile meat?
In Australia?
No.
So they can buy it and try it out, right?
No. I mean, I thought you said legal, but you know, crocodile
meat?
Oh,
it's illegal. Okay.
Crocodile meat? Are you serious? Let's stop the banner right there. Rizzo takes out PZ Kid. JYP...
I'm pretty sure there's like a cuisine like that, right?
I mean, people do eat snake, so...
Yeah. I've also tried silkworm before. Tastes good. I mean, I'm saying if they're like steak or something, and they can't eat cuisine. But, alright, they're gonna be pushing in the one-for-one trade, even with the pistols, though, so that's a good trade there for JYP. But Rekka Esports have all of the utility as well as the firepower, but... Well, hold that thought. This could be a round for JYP.
But, you know, we can't tell. Well, ACAP actually has the AK-47 right now, but he don't have armors. And he immediately goes down by the hands of Frost Missy. He's just A-Man on his own, running away with that USB. He needs to get a gun at the very least. Or, I mean, if he's feeling kind of confident, he can go ahead and go for the clutch. But we'll see. A-Man doesn't have any armor. USB, it's not going to do much against guys with helmets. And... Rekka actually has all the utility in the world, and he gets spotted as well.
That was close. He was about an inch before he could get spotted out by Frost Misty there, and if he was able to actually bypass that line of sight for Frost Misty, maybe he could have gotten the counter or to have stopped the bomb plant and stolen the weapon and fragged Frost Misty before they knew what was happening.
Nice try, Editon. But yeah, nonetheless... somewhat of a weak buy coming in for JYP. Just a couple of utilities. Celeste with a glass cannon, AWP. Celeste is actually burning down. X-Crit goes down immediately, and the action is still at A. Rizzo taking down Celeste. It's now 12. Still 12-2. Will it be a 12-3?
Wow, X-Crit playing around that smoke finds E-Man. And this last round in the first half looks to be in the hands of PZ Kid, but we've seen this happen already in the first game.
Yeah, we've seen that happen. They might be able to turn things around, and PZ Kid had the angle there. He kind of saw the silhouette, but it's not going to happen.
And that'll be the round for Rekka Esports, 12-13, three more. And they win this. It's all over. It's gonna be all over. GG, well played. Think about it.
GG, well played indeed.
But of course, this is the reset. We're on halftime. Second half, rather. And they can do what they did on the first game and maybe even better.
Maybe even better. Because JYP, they were able to turn things around. They are now dictating the momentum here for... the game, and yeah, we'll see. And it's actually starting to look like a B take here for JYP, and it's pretty standard play from Rekka Esports. And Frost Mace is gonna be the first person to find out that JYP is gonna go into the train. Bentet with that double kill, make that a triple kill with the headshot.
No, that was Rizzo, but he gets himself the second. No, it's okay. I thought it was like it looks like their shots are connecting, but it's actually their teammates who are getting the headshots.
Oh, yeah.
That was something.
But still, that is something. 2:14, just one more round to match point. One more round, and Rekka Esports will be flying to Australia,
where the kangaroos hop, and what else? The koalas sleep. Yeah, right.
Now the land down under.
Yeah, it is.
Where are stereotypes? No, we're not gonna go for stereotypes there. Bentet going in for the double kill. Rizzo takes down A-Man. Supersense takes down PZ Kid. And ACAP on his own against a three-man Rekka Esports.
It's ACAP against the world.
Exactly. And JYP, and if they want to stay in the game, ACAP needs to do a miracle here.
Yeah, and Rekka not looking to replicate what happened to them on the second half back at Cash, and they're just going to be JYP in dire straits. They have to come back. I mean, next round, it's still not over for them. They can push it into overtime, but it's going to take a whole lot of, well, perseverance and consistency. But Rekka Esports are looking to be unstoppable in this one, 2-15. JYP, what can they do?
Well, what JYP is doing right now, they are going in for the force buys. They are giving it their all. 3 AKs, a couple of Galils, and just the right amount of utility. They'll see if they can make it work this time around, if they'll be able to come back. And Rekka Esports, somewhat of an aggressive stance there. Very, very aggressive. PZK takes down Bentet. Over at A, and Rizzo is the first person is gonna respond, but ACAP takes him down. So now down to a 4v3 situation as SuperSys takes down ACAP, PZK takes down SuperSys as well. Now down to a 4v2 situation. Rekka Esports, they need to play it safe. JYP, they are gonna have the economical advantage here at this point as Celeste and Anna wipe everything out. 3-15, JYP is once again going back. I mean, is this deja vu? Am I seeing things all over again?
It could be, but Rekka Esports, they're going to be playing safe and not... Are they going to force buy into this one? I think no. They have so many rounds to work with, so I think just play it safe again. Give JYP a couple of rounds so that they can nurture their economy back to health, back to the point where they can full buy. Mm-hmm. And we'll see what happens after that.
But, you know, this isn't like 1.6. And in an eighth round of 1.6, you are expected to lose, but in CSGO, things are different. If you are in an eco round, you still have a chance to win here. So Rekka Esports still has a chance. As I say that, Celeste and PZK take down two guys from Rekka Esports. And Super just doing damage now, just down to Frost, Misty, and Bentet for Rekka Esports. And the bomb is now going to get rotated. Hold that thought. Frost, Misty is just going to be the sole survivor here for Rekka Esports.
And Ken, well, again, like I said, it's gonna be a tall task for JYP, but oh wait, Frost Misty trying to at least delay or stop the bomb plant there, but he won't succeed on a spawning mount and coming out through connector, and that's gonna be Rekka Esports still out of money to buy up. So there's gonna go for the eco here yet again, and JYP are starting to get some moolah. Lots of moolah.
Lots of moolah, and Rekka Esports is just saving up for the next round. Hopefully that will be the round that they will close out everything. And JYP, 4 AKs, AWP going on to Celeste. Oh, we'll see what's going to happen. They actually opted to... Rekka Esports actually opted to go for the armor instead of going for the defuse kit, just in case that, you know, they can be all cheesy and go for the ninja. They'd rather just go for the survival there.
That's definitely true.
And nothing else is happening here. Rizzo is actually in a pretty off angle. ACAP is actually right there. SuperSys, oh, he gets taken down by ACAP, and Rizzo already goes for the refrag, but Celeste, again, on fire with that AWP. It's just a 4v3 situation. Make that a 4v2 situation. Benta with a beautiful headshot onto A-Man's now down to a 2v3 situation. Rekka Esports still has the momentum. The bomb is not getting planted, and they're losing time, but Xcurrent on his own with that USB is just hiding in the smoke.
Man, Benta, you place any gun in his hand, and he will find ways to actually get kills with it. CZ headshot at mid-range. That's something.
I mean, you would expect to just use a CZ to, like, spray down the enemy close range, but if in the proper hands, a CZ can be a deadly weapon in mid-range, rarely, occasionally, in the long-range game.
But now here it is, the buy round of Rekka Esports. This is where JYP have to actually finish it off, but hold that thought. ACAP and Celeste with a double up setup here for JYP on T spawn, on T side.
On T side indeed. And ACAP immediately seeing if somebody's gonna aggressively push B, and he does see Xcurrent. Xcurrent goes down. Down to a 5v4 situation. Things are still calm nonetheless. Rekka Esports is pretty scattered. you're still heavily favoring A, and the bomb is at Pop Dog. Nothing much is happening here, but the bomb is now rotating to B. Well, it's actually saying Pop Dog, just waiting for the rotate. I think they're just gonna wait for an opening there. Ricket Esports, what are you planning? How are you gonna hold this offense by JYP?
But at least the sign right here for Ricket Esports is that if ACAP and Celeste miss their shots, they're gonna be easy targets for Ricket Esports. So at the same time, JYP on their side, of course, the minus one is definitely gonna help them out. And when these off shots actually connect, it's gonna be a different story. But now, we do see that Rasogan is spotting out PZ Kid there. Frost Misty still at B site. He can hear a couple of the footsteps from JYP, but he has to be careful. He has to be a little bit of a ninja here and remain quiet. Wait for that bomb plant. Try to peek in and maybe get the frags if he wants to, but not gonna happen, pal.
Not gonna happen, but the rotation is now coming in. Rekka Esports and Akka Banana are actually cleaning the house here. It's just Super Citizen and Benton on their own, and it's now down to a 2v2 situation. Benton is careful with guarding, and they are throwing the Molotov so that they can go in for the defuse, but the Molotov is gonna prevent the defuse from coming. It's just Celeste on his own. Celeste versus Super Citizen, AWP versus an M4. Celeste has his 5-7 out.
Where he is, though. He's trying to spray with the 5-7. He clutches it for JYP. Great job, and Rekka Esports have been thwarted yet again by the Malaysian team.
This is deja vu, and if this is indeed deja vu, Rekka Esports will be taking it. But JYP, they must be feeling pretty confident, especially during the first game. They know that they can do a comeback. Second game, I think their mindset is, we need to do a comeback this time around. Force an overtime. Force a game three.
Yeah, and of course with that, they shatter Rekka Esports economy yet again. And it's gonna be an eco.
It's gonna be an eco.
Oh, PZ Kid fearless here.
Ooh, Rizzo taking out PZ Kid now. PZ Kid has the AK-47. Let's see if it'll be able to do something there. Actually, sees Amen, but it's not gonna happen. It's now 4v2. Frost, Missy, and Bentet. Just chilling well there in Connector. Well, they're now in A site. And JYP, they have all the time in the world at this point. But, ooh, Celeste brings down. Actually, Frost Misty brings down Celeste into to 3 HP and just bent that on his own. He's not going to be able to do much at this point.
Wait, you can't count on bent that just yet. He's a god with his weapons. If he can hit the two shots, oh my goodness, bent it! Almost connecting the shot onto Celeste, who was only 3 HP. And that's what I'm talking about. He could have actually gotten the clutch there. But JYP have so much money to work with. 17-15, 8 more rounds.
I mean, that would have been big if Benton was able to connect that. He'll be able to pick up the AK-47. He'll be able to clutch it and actually win the game for Rekka Esports, but sadly, JYP didn't let that happen. No, Kaze's not gonna change his name to Celeste. I think it's just for this game.
Or, you know what, maybe he will. But honestly, I don't like when pro players change their names. It's confusing. That's the main thing that I don't like it. It's confusing.
Yeah, but you know, we can't do anything about it. It's their accounts. We can't do anything about
Still,
it.
Still, there should be some sort of rule. Like, if they're gonna be a pro player, they should have at least the one name to remember them. Because again,
one
like
name
I said,
to rule them all.
It's so confusing.
And the bomb is chilling there. Just outside Pop Dog in the stairs, in the ladder room. The 5v, still a 5v5 situation, and Celeste is pretty low. A double offset are coming in from JYP here. Let's see if it's actually gonna pull up. But Bentet takes down ACAP. Goodbye to that AWP. Celeste is pretty low with that AWP. We don't know if he'll be able to do much there. And yeah, I think the take is now going. JYP is now going for the B take, I think. Smokes. Going up all over, and PZ Kid just waiting patiently in the hallway, just waiting for, just trying
to. They're running the time really, really low here. JYP they don't have a lot of utility actually, so this could backfire for them if they push it too long. 25 seconds, they have no time at all to actually rotate, and Frost Misty is gonna get countered out there. But no, Bentet is actually holding his hat, and they're getting wiped, and that's going to be the win for Rekka Esports, 16-7.
And Rekka Esports will be flying over to Australia. They are the grand champion of the Shootout Season 3.
GG, well played, guys. And, wow, any final thoughts?
Well, JYP, they had the right mindset. They should have been actually be able to go for the comeback, but you know, it was a bit too late. They pushed the time on that last one. I mean, we can't blame him. The nerves are there. So, you know.
Yeah, there's not going to be a map 3 anymore, guys. It should have been Cobblestone if we did, get that 1-for-1. But Rekka wrecking it with a 2-0.
And the flame of Rekka will continue over onto the Zen League presented by ESL over in Australia. Well, they'll be fighting against 4 Australian teams and other teams from the rest of Asia.
Yeah, congratulations to Rekka Esports, but of course kudos to JYP for showing off a little bit of that skill. So we'll be hoping to actually cast the Zen League if we do have the chance.
If given the opportunity, yeah. We'll be providing the Southeast Asian coverage of that.
That's true.
But yeah, this has been Nomad, and alongside with me is
Asurai, one hell of a beast.
And thank you so much for tuning into the Shootout Season 3. Much love. Yeah. And hope to see you guys next time.
Yeah, and of course, this is brought to you by Mineski TV, the number one esports channel in the Philippines. So, ciao, guys. Bye-bye.